the cool, clean waters of Canada's North Atlantic Ocean. That's where our salmon farmers head out to work every morning to raise their fish. They grow their fish in the best place possible, their natural, native ocean environment. Salmon farmers have coexisted with traditional fishermen in these pristine waters for nearly 40 years.
I originally started raising Atlantic salmon when I was 15 years old in the summers in between school. The thing I'm most proud about is being able to bring a beautiful, healthy fish to the consumers at the end of the day.
With its smooth, buttery texture and mild, delicate flavor, Atlantic salmon is by far the most popular type of salmon enjoyed by consumers around the world. It's available fresh all year round in a variety of ways. Whole fish, fillets, portions, skewers, and specialty packs such as hot smoked, cold smoked, and burgers. No commercial fisheries exist for wild Atlantic salmon, but thanks to modern salmon farming, consumers do not have to go without. The salmon grown in Atlantic Canada began their life cycle as eggs, which are collected from adult salmon broodstock. The eggs are reared in land-based freshwater hatcheries for 12 to 18 months.
Once they get to a certain size, we move them into larger pens, and those pens are the ones they stay in until they reach their market size.
Salmon farmers are proud of the fish they grow and care about the environment in which they work.
We usually do a full visual check on the farm to make sure nothing's happened overnight. We get our underwater cameras set up before we begin feeding. We put our oxygen meters in to check the oxygen in the water, check the water temperature, make sure our cameras and our monitors are all set up, and then we start to give the fish their breakfast.
Farm salmon eat nutrient-dense dry pellets made from animal, plant, and fish proteins. No artificial dyes or growth hormones are ever used. Atlantic salmon are not genetically modified in any way. Farmers follow strict codes of practice to ensure their fish are healthy, properly contained, and waste is managed responsibly. They also keep stocking densities low so that the salmon have plenty of room to follow their natural schooling behavior. In fact, salmon occupy less than 4% of the space in their net pens. All Atlantic Canadian salmon farming companies are involved in third-party certification programs to ensure the highest quality salmon is produced. Atlantic salmon product can be traced back to the original farms where the fish was raised, including records of what they ate and how the farmer cared for them. Back on shore, state-of-the-art technology is used to process full-size salmon quickly, humanely, and at the ideal temperature to maintain the freshest quality. Farm salmon are processed, packed, and shipped to you typically within 24 to 48 hours. So the beauty of salmon is the fact that it arrives fresh right to your back door. Love this particular salmon. Look at this. He is shiny, he is gorgeous. He's packed in ice to make sure that the quality of your salmon when it arrives is in perfect shape. And stare at it in the eye. There's something about staring your salmon in the eye that's very important, because you want them to make sure they're nice and shiny and glossy. If you're looking at the salmon and if the eyes are all caved in and so on, it's not so fresh. And as well, when you open the cavity, you can see how beautiful and fresh the inside is. And it smells like the sea. And there's nothing any better than that when it smells like the freshness of the water. It also gives you a beautiful stock. So you could take, after I filleted the salmon, you could take all the carcasses and steam them or boil them and turn it into a beautiful stock for yourself. And you could pick all the salmon to do a nice mousse if you want to out of it, and so on and so forth. In my restaurant, I would right away take this salmon and I would assign somebody right from the box to make sure they fillet these salmon right away or steak them, depending on how many and which I would like to have. You could prepare your salmon in many different ways. We love to fillet it and give you a nice, beautiful portion, or to steak the salmon as well. So we're gonna show the methods in both ways so that you have a better idea of what's what. I like to lay it on its side and go to the thicker portion under the fin and literally cut down to the bone. And with my filleting knife, basically just follow along the bone section of the salmon, like so. And you can just fillet all the way down.
And from there, we'll trim this while we do the second side. At this point, what I'm going to do is take the underbelly out, fatty part, of course, and more bones right to the side, and then cut the underbelly right out. There we go. Remove this part and you end up with this gorgeous fillet. All right, at this point, you want to make sure that the pin bone is taken out of the salmon. So there's a little line of it that goes right across. You just pull one by one and use a pair of pliers. I find is probably the easiest way of doing this process. And from there, you take your salmon and you fillet it up. Beautiful little salmon steaks. Cut all the way across. This one is about 6 ounces, give or take, but there it is. So if you have a restaurant facility that doesn't have a huge amount of employees to be able to do all the filleting and so on, we'll do it for you. We'll get it all ready for you, skin off, ready to go, and you could serve it right into your restaurant as is. So a salmon approximately this size, it's about 5 to 6 ounces. You would sear, you want to already get that beautiful sear on one side at least, so that's what the consumer will see. But traditionally we would sear this in a frying pan for approximately 2 to 3 minutes on each side, and I would finish it in the oven, 350 or 400 degrees, depending on where you keep your normal oven at. And from there, you would use your temperature gauge to make sure it's in the internal temperature of 165 degrees or less. A lot of restaurants now will serve the salmon medium rare-ish, and we'll tell the guests that that's how it's gonna come, and if they prefer to cook a little more, then you can cook it a little bit more. But it's beautiful, especially with today's sushi, and people are used to eating smoked salmon and so on. So in restaurants nowadays, you're seeing everything filleted, and that is great and people love it. The consumer though grew up on eating salmon steaks, so we're going to show you the method of cutting the steaks to make sure that you're versed in all aspect of the salmon. But I find that in our restaurant we prefer to use the salmon fillet because it maximizes the amount of portions that you could get out of the salmon. So to cut the steak is pretty simple. You just pull the fin back and start right at the head and just go for it. And of course, then pull back, remove the head. I find it's easier. Then you have a better look and feel of what the steak is gonna look like and so on over here. And then decide at which point approximately how thick you want that steak to be. So depending on how big the salmon is, will vary in size between 5 to 6 ounces, sometimes 8 ounces, depending on how thick you're actually cutting that particular salmon. But it's as simple as finding the measurement and do your cut. You have to push a little harder to go through the main bone. And then you just pull your knife right through. And look at these beautiful steaks. So again, it's a tradition of what our family would have grew up on, you know, and then you can present it whichever way you prefer from there and cut all your steaks one after the other. Here's a quick recipe for you. Something very simple that you could enjoy in your restaurant that's pretty. So what I've done is I've got my pan nice and hot. I'm gonna put a little bit of olive oil in this case. See how my pan is nice and hot and sizzling. So next, I want to get a beautiful sear on it. So there we go. Nice sear. And then sea salt. Get a bit of pepper. So once we've seared the fillet on both sides for approximately 2 minutes or so and get that nice caramelization, we'll take the pan and place it right in the oven at 400 degrees for another
7 or 8 minutes. After we've pulled it out of the oven, we'll place it on our plate, but while it's cooking in the oven, we're gonna do a reduction of blueberries and balsamic vinegar and maple, and just do a nice drizzle over top of some asparagus. There's that really nice sear, beautiful color. And at which point then, we're gonna place it right into the oven. We're gonna do a fairly simple sauce. It's all ingredients that are readily available. We're gonna take a little bit of butter, approximately a tablespoon of butter, and melt it to the bottom of our pot, and add approximately a cup of blueberries into the butter. And the butter will give the blueberries a little bit of a shine. From there, I like to take the back of my spoon and crush a few of the blueberries into the butter so it starts to soften down the blueberries. I'm gonna take some balsamic vinegar and pour about a tablespoon of the best of balsamic vinegar as you could find. Oh, the aroma and the smells are wonderful. And from there, some Atlantic Canada maple syrup, of course, some of the best. And about the same amount, about a tablespoon of it. And from there, we will let this reduce into a beautiful sauce. And we'll let it simmer till it starts to boil. We'll throw a little bit of sea salt. Love throwing in a little pinch of sea salt. Always adds that little crunch too, if some of the sea, some of the salts have not totally dissolved, and a little bit of pepper. That's it. It's as simple as that. There's the salmon. Beautiful plate coverage. We're gonna add a few asparagus just for color. I like to work in odd numbers, so 3 asparagus on that sticking up. It's beautiful. And take this nice blueberry sauce, and we're gonna do just a nice drizzle. And that's it. On our plate. And voila.
As a chef, you could feel good about serving Atlantic salmon. Farmers grow it with pride in a sustainable way so that this popular fish will be available to enjoy for generations to come. Atlantic salmon, it's fresh, convenient, affordable, and delicious. Make it part of your menu today.